Hello. It's nice to be in a room with people and music. Thank you. gritting my teeth and smiling. Just been having too much fun. Hold on, that's enough. Let it go. Get up. Yes, your cab driver is calling you. It's getting late now, I think he's had enough. It's me. So I feel like Tom Jones. It's so nice to see you all here. But it is. Did a record of cover versions just before this business, the business started. Played a show at Austin Brothers. This is one of the songs from that. This is our version of a Billy Idol tune. Thank you. Billy Idol is familiar to you, yeah?
Yeah.
This
is called In My Room, which is, yeah.
It's kind of quite an old song, but it's quite a fitting song. lovers will always embrace in their favorite bar. The drinkers will drink forever under the ancient tree. The old couple are always together. Everyone, this is Ian Button on the drum kit, Eddie Lewis on the bass guitar, and Andy Strickland on the guitar. I should say that song we wrote, that was a loft song on a, the loft had a somewhat bumpy ending, and it was all right. After about 18 years, it was all right. So it was pretty sad. But and we worked on that song together. So it was really good doing that song and doing it with Andy. Doing it with Andy again. So it's a moment. I can't do emotion. Sorry, that all goes into the song. So anyway, I was taking the piss, but I actually meant it.
Just hug each other.
Yeah. Don't touch each other, God's
No, God.
In fact, I have to share with the loft, we did a reform gig after all those years, in the early 2000s, I think. And we finished the gig, and it was great. We finished at the Spitz, amazing night. We're like... It was the most fantastically awkward boom and hug that was. Not like that, really. Okay, this is called Joe Schmo and the Eskimo. With all his winnings, the Eskimo hit town with a view to making up for some long lost ground. They kept the bar open for an unspecified sum. He wanted it all, but most of all, he wanted some with purple and crimson. the circus hit town. Word of the foolish Eskimo had soon got round. But back in his hotel room, the walls were looking thin, and he was starting to get nervous about the circus breaking in. Well, Jo was in the kitchen, she'd almost had enough, but she liked the Eskimo too much. She could not call his bluff. She just had to wake him, mend his clothes, and make his bed. And every time she confronted him, this was all he said. He said, "I know, let's play with throwing it all away. That makes you Joe Shaw." So the hungry circus, it went from strength to strength, and no one seemed to notice that the Eskimo paid the rent. But he didn't care, because he lived his waking dream, and Mima on the outskirts, Joe could barely be seen. He just kept on winning, as the powerful often do. He knew he'd found the answer, but he knew it wasn't true. His mistress and his money stacked up on the shelf, and everything he had, he just wanted something else. Well, the gambling hall went quiet as the Eskimo walked in. He put all his money down, of course his wedding ring. His face showed no sign, with a hurricane in his head. And as he bribed the dice man, this was all he said. He said, "I know, let's play with throwing it all away. Let's see who's most unhappy at the end of the day.
Just makes things worse. Seems just give it, and if we get permission, among our chances, there's a chance we can choose. And then at the end, with uncertainty's permission, it's impossible to lose.
Go away. Does that train that's
church bell ring all the way through to the morning.
We could maybe go and stand in that room for like 30 seconds and then you could clap and come back. Is that, should we do that or should we just go for it now? Thanks very much for turning out as well.
Thank you.
Yeah, we'll pleasure. His plan is to, like, if we did get an offer, to do like one risky one followed by one you might know, so bear with us because this is the, we're going to do the risky one first, of course, you know.
Risk away.
Yeah, well, should we do
my wedding?
Got rebellion, there we go. It's got a really good slope of note, but yeah, no, she looks well. It's not so Sarah's version. Yeah, let's try and do this. Yeah, this is it makes me think of the late great Andrew Weatherall. This song came up as a result of a conversation with him, actually. I said I should write a song called Only Child, and we were chatting about it. So I finally got around to doing it. Only Child.
like 3 to 9. Back through the day all the way to the night. Boats of cargo ready to unload. With the palm of my hand.